wanted American control of the West. He also wanted scientific information, details about the land, its people, plants, and animals. Success on all these different fronts at once would require a special kind of leader, one with a broad range of knowledge in the natural sciences, an understanding of Native American ways, and highly developed wilderness survival skills. Jefferson found many of these abilities in a young Virginian he'd watched grow up and who had become his personal secretary, Meriwether Lewis. Captain Lewis, in turn, wrote William Clark, a friend and seasoned officer under whom he had served in the regular army.
If there is anything in this enterprise which would induce you to participate with me in its fatigues, its dangers, and its honors, believe me, there is no man on earth with whom I should feel equal pleasure in sharing them as with yourself.
The Mississippi River. On the other side of the Mississippi is Illinois. The Missouri River. This is where they both meet. Historic. Lewis and Clark at the Confluence Point. The crew of the Lewis and Clark expedition spent 5 months in winter camp at the mouth of Wood River. After that, they departed from this point. Right here. Keep walking all the way down.
That's their journal.
So they wrote the different activities they did. Yeah.
And so as we leave those stuff, we come over here and inside your outro. Your
what's for dinner, guys?
Other boats with it, so when they left, it was really a bit of a flotilla. Now, the other two boats were good-sized boats. They weren't as fancy as this one. But the, what they call the Red Pirogue, an open bow boat, think of a John boat, only bigger. It would have been about 30 feet long and have a small mast with it. It took 8 men to oar it, but this can certainly sit 13 on each side.
Okay.
Then the smallest one was the White Pirogue. And again, it was the smallest of the three, so it was slightly less than 30 feet. But it took 6 men to oar it. Now, the Red Pirogue had more cargo on it, more supplies. The White Pirogue carried all the camping equipment. So every night when they pulled up on shore, usually an island, it's the army. They take everything off the White Pirogue, strike camp. In the morning, strike camp, take it down, put everything back on the White Pirogue. And they used this boat for about a year.